The era of knights evolved gradually. The term knight originates from the Anglo-Saxon name for servant, knight. Indeed, most early knights were not much more than hired boys who performed military service and took oaths of loyalty to any well-to-do nobleman or warlord offering the most promise of money or war booty. The knight's era is often given as beginning in the year of our Lord, 800. This is the time of Charlemagne, also known as Charles the Great or Charles the First. However, I consider the beginning of the knight's era as the time of his grandfather, Charles. Charles added heavy armored cavalry to disciplined heavy infantry. The Battle of Tours earned Charles the cognomen of Martel, the Hammer. The important military achievement of Charles Martel was the victory at Tours. Historians cannot and do not overstate the importance of this campaign. Creasy argues that the Martel victory preserved the relics of ancient and the germs of modern civilizations. Gibbon called those 8 days in 732, the week leading up to Tours and the battle itself, the events that rescued our ancestors and our neighbors from the civil and religious yoke of the Quran. Paul Akers, in his editorial, says for those who value life and freedom, you might spare a minute sometime today and every October to say a silent thank you to a gang of half-savage Germans and especially to their leader, Charles the Hammer Martel. In the chaos and danger of post-Roman Western Europe, people had very little organized governmental protection from brigands and invaders. Local lords gathered around them, young, fighting-age men, to fend off rebellious vassals or conquering neighbors. These men, in turn, were rewarded with war booty for their service and loyalty. Soon, grants of land were made so the young soldiers could receive an income from those lands and afford the high cost of outfitting themselves with horses, armor, and weapons. The era of the medieval knight had begun. The word chivalry comes from the French word chevalerie, which means skills to handle a horse. The ability to handle a horse, especially in combat, was of utmost importance to a medieval knight. As the Middle Ages progressed, the term chivalry began to take on new meanings. In AD 1095, the Greek emperor in Constantinople, Alexios I, asked Pope Urban II to save the Eastern Roman Empire from the invading Saracens. The Pope needed the support of the nobles and knights of Europe to remove the Saracens from the Holy Lands. By bestowing the title of Christian warriors to the knights, the Pope began the evolution of a code of conduct that all knights were supposed to follow. The protection of the poor, women and children, and defense of the church were just some of the chivalry codes that a knight was supposed to always obey. Here is a very incomplete list of knights who saved Western civilization in the name of Christendom for people that they would never meet. Included is a very incomplete listing of their efforts of historic significance. Richard the Lionheart at the Battle of Arsuf, 1191. Janos Hunyadi at the Siege of Nandorfavar, 1456. Nicholas Graf Salm at the Siege of Vienna, 1529. Jean de la Valette at the Great Siege of Malta, 1565. Miguel de Cervantes at the Battle of Lepanto, 1571. Jan Sobieski at the Battle of Vienna, 1683. Eugene Savoy at the Battles of Vienna. Zenta, 1697, Petro Varadin, 1716, Belgrade, 1717. In my younger years, I had only known two of the names in this list. Richard was a character in the screenplay of the 1938 film, The Adventures of Robin Hood. Cervantes was the author of Don Quixote. Who knew that Cervantes gave up an arm as a knight fighting for a moral cause? Their sacrifices and the sacrifices of the number and names of knights known only to God are what have allowed our Western civilization the freedom to produce the works of Shakespeare, Newton, Jefferson, Beethoven, Lincoln, Edison, and Einstein. May God the Father, through Jesus Christ and the Holy Spirit, preserve our faith and freedom today and for all tomorrows. Amen.